Hey guys, August 7th at 4:07, so I'm starting to feel a little tired and losing my balance, so I'm trying to finish the rest of this water before I go to bed. So then that way I've had three of these today, and one cup of coffee. I'm just going to finish this first. I'm going to stop talking about donations. It's just that a lot of people have asked how they could help me, so just putting that out there. But again, it's not mandatory, like I keep saying. It's just if you want to help out. So the thing, when I don't like what I'm drinking, I just drink it fast. I hate water. I hate the taste of it. And this, if it's boiled, even then I don't really like it, so I've been just drinking it fast. I've been cutting off Speckle's mats too, so he's almost all free of mats. So I'm trying to stay dehydrated, because I think when I sleep too much, then I don't get enough water. And like I said, I have cut down on coffee. I'm probably going to have another cup of coffee because I'm trying to stay awake. Because water doesn't really help me stay awake, but it does, but then it doesn't. So I grabbed another box. The one that is from the, what do you call it? The entranceway that Josephine wouldn't let me break up, because I need a bigger box for the crafts, because I can't sleep until this is all done, and I don't want to eat until this is done, because I know that's going to put me to sleep, because food and TV, both of them, those two things always put me to sleep. It doesn't matter what I'm eating, doesn't matter what I'm, watching on TV. I just always fall asleep, even when I eat a salad, like the bok choy salad I've been eating, and I still fall asleep. When I eat oranges, I still fall asleep. Because earlier when I filmed, when I was having the orange, not too long after that, I took a nap. So, for some reason, no matter what, food and watching TV always puts me to sleep. But then, eventually, I do get to the point where I get too tired and too hungry, so I have to sleep. Eat, watch TV, sleep, and I'm done Gilmore Girls, so, yeah, probably going to fall asleep to Puppets Who Kill, because I got back into that show again, so, I love Puppets Who Kill. I hope it comes back. I don't think it will, but, yeah, you guys know I'm obsessed over that show, still, Bill. And then Bill, I'm looking at my Puppets Who Kill thing up there. But yeah, I'm starting to get tired, so I just want to finish this off. So let's do it. And I think I'm going to leave my computer on the ground for now, because then that way I can play cat TV for the cats, and they'll be closer, so I might record that. I was going to put the batteries in the laser toy, but I'm going to wait till tomorrow, because I'm just getting to the point where I'm almost tired, where I can't stay up, but I want to get this done. So I'm going to put my music back on, but I feel I need some help to stay up, so I'm going to play Headstones, I think. So stay tuned. They're, as you guys know, they're like one of my favorite bands. Hugh Dillon is my idol. And at that flashpoint, I don't know, maybe I'll fall asleep to that now. I'm still behind on seasons, so I have to watch that when I'm awake, because I never fully finished Flashpoint, because it kept going on demand, and then it was off, and then it was on demand, and it was off, and it's like, I want to watch the last two seasons when I'm awake, so one of these days, so bear with me. I'm going to put on some music here, the Headstones, my favorite band. Favorite Canadian band other than Sum 41, but Sum 41's almost not around anymore, so. But yeah, I love Headstones. They're the only band that I traveled to go see in another city. So I went to Victoria, the meet and greet, and then the following week he came to Vancouver. So went to Victoria just for them, and then the following week I went to Vancouver, and that's how Hugh Dillon and I kind of became friends in a way. We're not really friends, but he knows who I am and like my story and all that. So yeah, it makes me feel special when I see him. So I hope they come to Vancouver soon. So yeah, I'm gonna play you Headstones here on Phantom Stories. Check them out. Before I fall down. Trying to charge my phone at the same time. Actually. Beauty of the tripod. Yeah, I love the Headstones. I'm actually too tired to move the computer as well. So, Headstones are under my motivation. So,
Don't.
oops. That's not what I wanted. Motivational. So yeah, they're underneath my motivational playlist on YouTube. I'm gonna go all the way down to the bottom to get to them. Or should I play? No. I feel like Headstones. I need to wake up music. But here we go, Headstones. After an hour. After an ad. Oh, and check out my videos. I do have a few videos on Headstones when I was at the concert, meeting Hugh Dillon, talking about Hugh Dillon, stuff like that. So I got tons of videos on Headstones, but I love them. And I hope you guys could hear this because it's getting late, so I don't want the volume too loud. About my craft stuff. That's my idol. Oh, I love the song too. See, it's picking me up. to wait. It's a good time to have a week. You got a delicious job. Feeling reckless, doing the best. No, I can't remember the lyrics. Sorry. I'm too tired. But that's how they go here. Oh, this is not a good song. Actually, I want to use the computer. Stupid ad.
Ava will need more green crayons because, well, frauds. Charlie's gonna lose his pants. His pants. With Walmart prices.
I wasn't gonna put the computer back, but since I had to pull out the table, I might as well. That would be it. Trying to get a photo with Hugh Dillon. Seven now. And it's clean. I didn't get a photo, I think. If you need to find a way to stay up, play music, and rock out too.
Let someone escape, scented animals. Tickle your senses.
Something is making us like, is this an owl, a cat, or a bat?
Gonna play Headstones.
Thank you. Listen, there's a good chance somebody's trying to hack your website right now. You've got to make sure you're covered. I'm talking.
Well, that's kind of uneven, so I would have stopped this and recontinue.